Hello friends, we have gone through, I think we have gone through the catheters, we have gone through the sheets, various different sheets, we have discussed the sheets, and we have discussed the cath lab. Cath lab is without a guidewire, without a sheet, or without a catheter is not possible. All the catheter intervention and diagnostic processes or procedures are done with a catheter, and the catheter needs a guide wire. And for the guide wire, to negotiate the guide wire, we need a sheet also. But the essential part is when you use a needle, then what happens is when we puncture the artery. When we puncture the artery, we need an initial guide wire so that we will be having an access through the guide wire. Now, this is the access guide wire we can have. There's one more. If this is a femoral, we will go through this. We'll use a 3.038 inches. Guide wires are measured in inches. They are not measured in mm's or gauge or French. They are measured in
inches.
So this you have to remember, and this length of this initial excess guide wire is around 38 inches or 30 centimeters. Now the thing is, the thickness of the guide wire is in inches. It is 3.82. It can go lesser than that. It can go to 0.008 inches. Sometimes it is 0.006 inches. But now we never find those guide wires. Actually, we don't use it mostly in the more sophisticated in the neuro vessels, we use those guide wires. But here we are using 0.038 inches guide wire for the initial access in the femoral artery. This need not to be coated. This need not to be Teflon coated guide wire. It is a stainless steel, and there is a spring over here. And the spring, what happens is, you see this is happening.
Yes.
This is a spring. What happens is there is a core inside this, and that is a steel core. You see here the bending is a little difficult. It doesn't bend so easily, but here if you see, the bending is very easy. You can see the bending, it's very easy. Why it is so? Because this is going to be in the artery, or this is going to be in the vessel, or the part where we want to go. So we are at the point of interest, wherever it is, or the site of abnormality, we want to go there. So we need a tip that is very soft enough. There is a guide wire, there is a wire inside this to hold this. So you can see this. This is because of the guide wire inside it. It holds, and then it falls down because it takes the shape of its own. And that wire is made up of tungsten or something like that. It's a very stiff one, but still it remains floppy because it is only hair thin guide wire inside it. So we will be having the photographs of it, and we'll be discussing it in the PPT also. That time you will be able to see the structure of this guide wire. But basically, I want you to know this. This is the initial access guide wire. This comes with a sheath. Sometimes it doesn't come with a sheath. So you have to know that whenever you are going to give a sheath, or whenever you are going to give a needle, the needle should be of such a bore that it should this guide wire should be able to we will be able to introduce this guide wire through that needle. All right. So when they say 3/8 guide wires, okay. When you are putting a femoral sheath, you have to use this guidewire, so you need a compatible needle. And the needle is always measured in gauge. Catheter is measured in
French.
Sheath is measured in French. Okay? The length of the catheter, guide wire, sheath is measured in centimeters. Okay? Now, this is 30 centimeters long. Actually, it is 40 centimeters long. Okay? So, 30 to 40 centimeters guide wire is enough for you to insert a sheath into the system, wherever you want to go. Now, you are puncturing the needle, the femoral artery, you need a 3/8 guide wire. They won't say 0.38 inches guide wire, they will say 0.38 guide wire we need. So, we have, this is, because we are taking an excess and we are going to introduce a sheath, we need a shorter guide wire. Sometimes what happens, the femoral artery is a little wibbly wobbly, or it's not in a smooth structure. The structure inside the body, is not smooth. It differs from patient to patient. If the patient is having atherosclerotic disease, the negotiation of this wire is very important. What happens is you have to again put another guide wire. So what happens is once you take an initial puncture needle and sometimes you have to take a hydrophilic guide wire, and it has to be a longer length. So it can go, and we can dock it in the abdominal aorta. We can dock it in the abdominal aorta, and but we have to see that when we are introducing the sheath, this. We are having an excess. We need a shorter guide wire. Always take a shorter guide wire. It's really easy. Very easy to handle. Because if you're using this long guide wire, now you see this long guide wire. Now this will take a longer time, and this happens now. It has fallen down over here. It should not fall down, first thing. Second thing, you have to, there is a lot of contamination, and sometimes what happens, this guide wire may come out, or it may get kinked, then it will have a problem. So always, when you are having an excess, you are going to take a shorter guide wire. When you take a shorter guide wire, and now this is steel coated, this is a steel spring over on this. You can see minutely, if you see, there is a spring, and just because of the spring, it is coming back down over here. Alright? Now, this you have to make sure, mug it up, memorize it in such a way that you will never ever make a mistake in choosing a guide wire. Femoral access, always use a stainless steel short guide wire with a floppy tip of a 3 to 4 mm J guide wire it is. 3 mmJ, if they call it 3 mmJ guide wire. So you keep it aside. Now we will go to another guide wire. Now there are various accesses we can take. If we are in the artery, we are in the cardiac unit, so we are going to only deal with veins or arteries. So our aim is to go to the heart, the cardiac coronary arteries, or to the heart itself, the various chambers of it. But what happens is, you can take any access. You can take it in the radial, you can take it in the brachial, you can take it in the femoral. Sometimes people can use any part. Wherever you can get an artery, you can get inside it. Because in the emergency, you have to see which artery is palpable, which is more reachable, which is more preferable, and how long you're going to take to finish off the case. But in some cases, it is mostly generally required that you will always use a bigger artery. You will always choose a bigger artery, and that is only femoral artery. You won't go to the carotid artery straight away. You won't go to the jugular straight away. You will always find a femoral access first, because that is the most easier and more what do you call it? We can handle it very well. If there is a complication, we can handle it very well. But if it is elsewhere, then it will be a trouble. Now, femoral access is the first choice, always the first choice. But nowadays what happens is the people are not having that much of time. They want to get in the hospital and they want to get out of the hospital as soon as possible. So what they do is, they say, if you can do it with hand, if you can do it with the radial axis, it would be preferable, more preferable. Now, radial artery is at least 3 to 3.5 mm artery. It's a huge artery. There is one another artery, there is an ulnar artery, but it is having a few layers of muscles over here so that it is well protected. There are two arches in the hand, okay, in the palm of the hand, you can see over here. Sometimes you can see it in the x-rays also. There is one radial arch and there is one ulnar arch. What happens is their duty is to supply blood to the phalanges. They have to be. And if now we prefer the radial artery because it doesn't hamper the supply to the phalanges. So radial artery, if we are taking a radial artery, we will always take a hydrophilic guide wire. Hydrophilic guide wire. It's shorter in length and you can see the tip of it is straight. But the tip is also floppy. Now, in the radial artery, you can put from 4 French to 5 French, 6 French and 7 French sheath. It can be from 5 centimeters to at least 17 centimeters long. Okay, it can just go up to your brachial level. That much of artery that sheaths are available, and those are radial sheaths. And sometimes in femoral also we use longer sheaths. But if you are taking a radial access, you have to have a shorter guide wire. Why you need a shorter guide wire? Because it's very easy to handle, and you will be able to negotiate the sheath in the vessel. You'll be able to insert the sheath in the vessel very smoothly. Or else, if you take a longer guide wire and you're doing a smaller artery over here, it will be a trouble for you. Because you have to handle so many things at the same time. You have to compress the artery so that there will be no bleed. As soon as you puncture, what happens? You're causing an injury to the vessel. When the vessel is injured, it tends to bleed. It may form a clot, but that's why we want to put a sheath. Now, if we want to put a sheath, we need a guide wire, and that guide wire has to be a very small length. All right, in the radial arteries, in the femoral artery, shorter length guide wire. In the radial arteries, you have a smoother guide wire, smaller in length, and plus it is floppy and it is hydrophilic. Why it is hydrophilic? It is water loving. Water loving means what? Because what happens is, when we are putting only the needle would be inside the vessel. And when we put this guide wire, what happens is, if it is not floppy, now this is a little bit stiffer. You can find the stiffness over here, and you can see the floppiness over here. Both do the same thing. Both are of the same thing, but they have a different, they are used in different sites actually. So you have to know this. If it is femoral, you are going to use a stainless steel, 30 to 40 centimeter length of guide wire. And this is in the radial, you are going to use hydrophilic, 30 centimeters or 40 centimeters long hydrophilic guide wire. It's a hydrophilic guide wire. Now it has a floppy. You can see. Now this is more. This is having a bend over here, and this is more straighter. Straighter means what happens is you don't go into the adjoining vessels. The vessels are coming from the heart like this, and these vessels, and you have to go inside this. What happens is sometimes it can go into the smaller one. It can go into the smaller one. Now this is my smaller finger. So okay, it will go into this artery. Now that may cause another problem for that. So you need this this guide wire, so that you will be able to negotiate the vessel properly. You'll be able to have an access to the artery properly, and it will not cause any harm to the patient. Now these two guide wires are aside. There's another guide wire. What happens is after insertion of the sheath inside this, over this guide wire, we do it over. Actually, the guide wire is inside the sheath. Inside the sheath, but we say we are going to insert the sheath over the guide wire. So once we put the sheath inside, we have a constant or permanent access to the vessel. It may be artery, it might be vein, or it might be the body. Anyway, we have a constant access to that, so we have to keep this aside. We keep this aside, and then we have to decide what type of patient we are having. If the patient is very obese, is a very fragile patient or a very weak patient, then you have to make a choice between wires, whatever you're going to do. And what type of procedure you are going to perform is also important in choosing these guide wires. Now, these are various shapes of the guide wires. This, we will go for the first one. Now, this is a simple Teflon-coated guide wire. There is a simple Teflon-coated guide wire. Now, we have seen a stainless steel, bare metal, guide wire. Now you can see this here. There is a difference between this and there is a difference between this also. Now these are the main guide wires we are going to use in the diagnostic or a therapeutic procedure. All right, when we are using these guide wires, now they have certain limitations, and they are having certain purpose according to the length and size of the guide wire. Okay, now when we have an access to the artery or the vein, we are not going to use the shorter one, because if you are taking it in the peripheral or you are taking it in the femoral, you have to go here. Now this guide wire is not going to reach here. This guide wire is not going to reach here. So you will need a better, longer guide wire. First preference is given always to the Teflon-coated guide wire. Why is the Teflon-coated guide wire? It acts as a slippery guide wire when it comes in contact with the with the blood or with the fluid. Now, once this happens. No, you have to go up to the heart. Now, if I'm putting it from the femoral, I'll go from here like this. The shape of this will be coming like this. Now, it will be, I'll tie it like this. Okay. Now, here, if this is the femoral, we go like this, and then go into the ascending aorta. Ascending aorta, transverse aorta, and the descending aorta. This is abdominal aorta. This is the iliac structure of it. All right. Now, when we are going, when we want to do something in the heart, we will always need a guide wire to negotiate the catheter over there. We need to negotiate a catheter, so that we will be able to reach that point, and we will be able to diagnose and plan a therapy, therapeutic or intervention procedure for that person. Now. The initial length of this guide wire is 140 centimeters. You can see 140 centimeters. Now this is a Teflon coated guide wire. Always use a Teflon coated guide wire for accessing the artery to the heart. All right. Now this comes in various different measures. There is a 0.5 from 2.5 0.025 inches to 0.38 inches. I said there is another one. 2.1 also is there. 1.8 also is there. 145 centimeters. 1.8 guide wire is there. Sometimes 1.8 wire will be using a 1.8 guide wire. It's more thinner than this. So we will be using it in more pediatric people. Pediatric patients. So we need a guide wire to access a certain site where we are going to perform a diagnosis or a therapy or an intervention. We don't say therapy, we will say intervention. Okay, it can be of any form. Intervention is, it might be a plasty, it might be a blocking of the artery, it might be something else. It can differ from the problem the patient is facing. So to negotiate a catheter, you need to have a longer length guide wire, so that we will be introducing a catheter over this guide wire. Okay, why we need a guide wire? Because the catheter is made up of plastic or polymer or something like that. So what happens is it may get kinked while negotiating the artery through various different structures of the body. So it may, there are lots of arteries in the body coming out of the aorta, and if the catheter sticks inside the body, in one of the arteries, it may damage that artery, and the supply of that particular part which the artery is supplying will be stopped, or there might be an injury and there might be a bleed inside the body. So we have to see that the catheter is always introduced upon a guide wire, and that too, if it is an aorta, it's a bigger aorta, it's a bigger artery, so we will always negotiate it with a Teflon coated 3.8 or 3.5, 0.35 or 0.38, alright? Sometimes we need 0.25, sometimes we need 0.21, sometimes we need 0.18, alright? Now, this is 0.35, right? So we will keep it aside. Now we know this is a Teflon coated 145 centimeter with the same this thing, like in the steel one you have seen, the introducer one. Now you can see there's a floppy over here, so that it should not harm the vessel inside. Wherever it goes, it should not harm any other structure. Along the course of its the negotiation, whatever. Now we'll keep this aside. Now we will go to another guide wire. What happens is sometimes we have a problem. We face a problem. Sometimes this Teflon guide wire may not be able to go through certain structures in certain parts of the aorta or the artery. It will not be. We would not be able to negotiate the Teflon coated because it's a little stiffer. And what happens is that there are sometimes there will be a bend over here, sometimes there will be a bend over here, sometimes there will be a bend over here, or the artery may be having all sorts of arthrosclerotic plaques inside. In the aorta also it's possible, in the iliac also it's possible, in the radium also it's possible. So that time we need a very soft guide wire, and it should be hydrophilic, mostly hydrophilic. It should mostly it is 3.5 guide wire, 0.35 guide wire, and it is hydrophilic in nature. Why it is hydrophilic in nature? So that it should not cause any harm to the vessel. We are here to diagnose the patient, and we don't intend to cause any harm to the patient. We want to see the patient walking, we want to see the patient out of the hospital as soon as possible. So we conduct interventions with the use of guide wires and catheters. Now this is the guide wire to negotiate a catheter over this to the heart. Now if it is in the radial, you go through this like this, then it comes like this. If it is in the femoral, it goes like this. okay, because you're coming from down. Now, here, if you're going, you're choosing the right right radial, then it will go through, go like this. Now, this will be the course, and if you go going through the left radial, the course will be like this. Okay. Now, this is 145, though. Generally used, the catheter, the wire that is generally used is 145 centimeter catheter. Most of the catheters are 110 at the most, 110 centimeters long. At the most, some are 125 long. Some catheters are different catheters. They are 125 centimeters long, and some catheters, some balloons and all those intervention things are more than 135 centimeters. Now this is now 100. We are having only 145 centimeters now with us. So you are not going to negotiate a catheter over this. Means if you want to do an intervention over this, you will not do an intervention over this. This catheter, if you want to exchange the catheter, you will not be able to do it with this type of catheter because it's 145 centimeters long. This introducer guide wire is only 145 centimeters long. It may be Teflon, it may be Teflon, or it may be what do you call it? Hydrophilic guide wire. Okay, you have to know the difference between this, and you have to gauge when you are selecting a patient, when the patient comes to the table, you have to know the background or the history of the patient. You need to watch the physique of the patient. You need to observe the physique of the patient. You need to know what is wrong with the patient, and then only you will be able to choose these guide wires. Okay. But preference would be Teflon coated. And this would be the ultimate guide wire to introduce certain things inside the body, inside the vessel. Alright? Now, this is 145 centimeters. Okay? 145 centimeters, you can see this. 145 centimeters. Okay? It goes. Plus minus a little bit, but it's not that much. It depends upon the company that is giving you the catheter, the guide wires. All right, and suppliers of the guide wires are different. Now, this company is different. The company who supplies hydrophilic guide wires may be a different company. This one is also a different company. Sometimes some companies prefer manufacture the both these guide wires and they supply the both one. But you have to know who, irrespective of the supplier or the manufacturer, you have to know that these guide wires, the initial insertion or the catheter insertion guide wire, should be 145 centimeters long at least. You cannot go for 60, you cannot go for 70, you cannot go for 90. You have to have 145 centimeter guide wire. And that too, it should be 35 inches. 35 inches. And there can be choices. Intervention is such a concept that you are trying to correct certain disorder in the body without a surgical procedure. This is minimally invasive procedure. So we need, for a minimally invasive procedure, we need various types of guide wires. Alright? Now, this guide wire we have learned, and we will be talking about it in the PPT when we are when it will be available. Now, sometimes what happens is when we put a catheter, we have to remove that catheter. You have seen many times it is that certain catheter doesn't work. Certain catheter doesn't fulfill the purpose that it is supposed to. So we will have to make a choice that time to use a different catheter. When we are using a different catheter, we have to take a longer guide wire. And this is another thing, but this is very small guide wire. Then we're going to talk about it. Now we need a longer guide wire. Now I'm showing you a different type of a guide wire that is very long. Okay, this is very long. You can see this, the length of this guide wire. So this is the guide wire. Sometimes I told you that we need to exchange certain catheter. A catheter which doesn't serve its purpose has to be replaced with some other catheter. It should be of a different shape. We have seen different shapes in the catheters. And now you can just compare these guide wires together and you will see the difference between these two guide wires. Now I said the initial catheter introducer guide wire would be of 145 centimeters. Now you see this guide wire, I'll compare these two together. You see, this is still longer. This is still longer. Why it is longer? Because what happens when we put this guide wire inside the body, when we put this guide wire inside the body, we introduce a catheter over it. Once we introduce the catheter, we know that the catheter is of no use to us. So what we do is we remove this guide wire and we keep it aside, and then we will reintroduce another guide wire through the same catheter, which is not going to be used. We are going to introduce the same guide, another guide wire, and it will be having a longer length. It will be having a longer length. Alright. Now this guide wire will go, and we will be able to, what happens is we will be able to negotiate the path, the wibbly wobbly path, which is not a normal path, with this guide wire. Now, because why we are putting this guide wire? Because we want to exchange certain catheter. The catheter is already here in place. So what we do is we introduce this guide wire inside, and then we will remove the catheter over this. We'll remove the catheter over this. And we'll keep this in the same place. We'll keep it steady in one place. And why we need a different catheter, take one catheter from there. Take one catheter from there. In the blue one. So what happens is, when the catheter is 100 centimeter long. Any given normal catheter is 100 centimeter long. Alright? You have to understand this. Understand this. 100 centimeter long is the catheter. Get me the catheter. Yeah. I'll take another big catheter. This is 125 centimeter long. Okay. Now, what happens is, if this catheter is inside, if I put, where is this? Okay, I'll use this catheter. I'll show you. Oh, means it will be easy for you to understand. If I introduce this catheter, it is a little bit, just because it is a slippery one, it has to be wet. It is not wet. Now you see this catheter. I say we have taken a catheter that is 125 centimeters long. You can see on the hub it is written over here 0.38. We have taken a guide wire 0.35. Yet it was a little difficult because it is not slippery. If there is some water inside this, if it is very lubricated, then this negotiating of this guide wire would have been easy. Now what happened? This is 0.38, 1200 psi pounds per square inch. Okay, that is the pressure we are going to inject contrast with. That is the maximum you can use, the pressure you can use in this with this catheter. Here you see it's a 4 French catheter, and it is 125 centimeters. Now what happens is already 125 centimeters, and you have introduced this catheter. And if you want to exchange it, sometimes what happens is, if you want to remove this catheter from this guide wire, say I'll pull it from here. Okay, only this much part of the guide wire remains in the body. And now here what happens is you hardly can catch the tip. Alright, you can hardly catch the tip. So what we have to do is we keep this catheter over here. We keep the catheter inside the body, and what we do is we will not be able to pull it out. We will take a Teflon guide wire. Where is the Teflon guide wire? This is it. Oops. Okay. Now, this is a Teflon coated guide wire. This will go easily, I suppose. Because it doesn't need water. It doesn't need blood. You can see it has come out quickly. Now, what happens is, now, if this catheter I have introduced over here and it's of no use in the body, what I will do is I will keep this catheter over here in the body itself and I will remove this. I'll remove this catheter, guide wire. Once I remove this guide wire, I'll take another longer guide wire. I'll take another longer guide wire and I'll just see if I have. This is not the way to put it inside because we need an introducer. Introducer for the guide wire always. Now we have introduced this longer guide wire. Now you see the guide wire has come out of here and yet I'm having this long length. Okay? This is the negotiable length I'm having over there. Because this much part is inside. In my hand. So what happens is, I leave the catheter over here. I leave the catheter over here, and then I will remove the guide wire like this. I'll remove the guide wire. When I remove the guide wire, I'll remove it like this. Once I remove it, I have a ample of length in my hand. Ample of length in my hand, so that I can reintroduce another catheter over it. So this guide wire is known as an exchange length. Generally, it is 260 centimeters long. 260 centimeters long. The thickness of this guide wire is 0.35 inches. Okay? 0.35 inches. It is Teflon coated. Sometimes it is blue, sometimes it is black. Some manufacturers give Teflon is what you have seen in your cookery. You have a Teflon coated non-stick. Non-stick vessel utensils you have, that Teflon is used over here. It is coated with this Teflon, and it is it doesn't get contaminated, it doesn't get much messy, and it is very easy to clean also, and it is very easy to negotiate also. It acts between the steel guide wire and the hydrophilic guide wire. It will have the similar features of those. It will be stiff, but it will also be slippery. But it will not be of the same length. Now, the catheter, the guide wire I'm showing here is a amplas guide wire. It is known as Amplas guide, right? You can see this is also a Teflon coated guide, right? And you can see this is also a Teflon coated guide, right? But this is more supple. This is more stiffer. This is more stiffer. Why it is more stiffer? Can you tell me? It is more stiffer because what happens is when we are putting another catheter over here, if we are putting a catheter of a bigger caliber, of a stronger caliber, then it will be this floppy guide wire will not be useful. What happens is when pushing the guide wire, this may keep like this. This may buckle. So we have to see that, and we are going to use a stiffer guide wire when we are going to exchange. Now this comes in floppy also. These comes in floppy, but when we are using a sturdier structure inside the body, we need to have a stiffer guide wire, and that is known as an Amplas guide wire. Okay. Now these Amplas guide wires are of different types, and they come in different bores also. Mostly they come in 3.5, and some come in 0.38. Now you can see the similar one before we have seen. This guide wire we have used for introducing the sheath. Now this guide wire is more like it, but it is more stiffer. You can see, very stiff. Very stiff, stiffer than this Amplas guide wire. You can see, it is more stiffer. Why? Because the thickness of this guide wire is 0.38. 0.38 inches, and we have to sometimes introduce certain instruments in the body. They need a very stiff support. Certain instruments that we introduce in the body need a stiffer support, a sturdy support. For these, we use these type of. Is there any coating on this? Yes, there is a coating. Some are having Teflon coated. It's a gray. Gray color. It is here. It's a blue color, a green color, and the other one was having a blue color. Okay, you can see differentiate the colors over here. And this is steel, totally steel. Some guide wires are steel guide wires, straight up. Some guide wires are steel guide wires because they are for more sturdier structures. They are for more sturdier instruments that we are going to introduce into the body. Now, what happens is, I have shown you for the exchange of it. Now, the exchange length guide wires are 260 maximum, but they can be of 300 centimeters also. Why? Because sometimes the catheters are 135. If we want to introduce 135 catheter inside the body, then you need a longer guide wire, and that has to be 300 centimeters. 260 centimeters may serve the purpose, but you will be walking on the edge when you are using the 260 centimeter catheter guide wire. You'll be as if you're walking on the edge of something where you can fall both the sides. So you want to fall on the right side, so you will always be safer, and you will always use a longer length that will keep you comfortable, and you will not be bothered about falling on the other side. You will fall inside the body itself. All right. So you are going to use these are 300 centimeters Teflon coated guide wires, and exchange guide wire comes in thermo guide wires also. You can see the thermo guide wire. This is also a 260 centimeters thermo guide wire. It's a hydrophilic guidewire. Sorry, it's not a dermo. Dermo is a company. It's in my. It comes as if it is always. I'm saying dermo, dermo. That's why it comes dermo. All right. Now this is 260 centimeters long. This also serves the same purpose. It is only for the exchange of certain catheter or certain device in the body. Alright? It is only for the exchange. If it is little sluffer, suppler instrument, then we use this guidewire. If it is stiffer or it is a very sturdy one, you will use a bigger guidewire. But then the choice is Teflon coated. For simple negotiation, you will be using only dermo guidewire. Alright? Now, this is done with it. Now, there is another guidewire. There is another type of a guidewire. This is of a simple, this is more thinner than other guidewires we have seen. Now, you have seen a radial puncture. You have seen a femoral puncture. You have seen these guidewires being used to introduce the catheters inside. But you have also seen, sometimes you will see that to introduce a balloon or to introduce a stent, we use a different guidewire. And that is, and that too, it goes into the coronary artery. Or an artery of a very thin caliber. Necessarily not coronary artery, it may be of any other artery. It is of a thin caliber. So you are going to use this guide wire. It is one for, they are called micro guide wires. These micro guide wires, they come in Teflon coated, they come in hydrophilic coated also, they come in steel also. The steel tip will be there, hydrophilic tip would be there. And the steel tips are of different weights. They're 3, 6, 9, 12, like that, weights are there. What happens is when you go into the artery, there might be a block at the start itself and it will not go inside. So you have to dig through it. So you need a digger. You need some shovel where you can negotiate into the artery straight away. This guide wire is used to introduce certain objects into the artery. Thin. Same. All the guide wires are doing something. They are supposed to guide the things that you need in the artery. Okay. Now when this, what happens is we have to go across the abnormality in the artery or the abnormality where we are going. We are supposed to diagnose or we want to intervene over there. We carry out an intervention, so we need a thinner guide wire. This is a micro guide wire. It comes in various shapes. It is 0.0014 inches. 0.0014 inches. There are 0.008 inches also. There are 0.0010 also. 0.0019 inches also. These guidewires are manufactured for certain purposes. If the delicate structures are always negotiated or accessed with this. These guidewires. So you have seen these guidewires, and you have to memorize these guidewires and see the structures of it and various different uses of it. When you come to know, when you memorize it, it will be easier for you to handle these guidewires when they are inside, when we are using it for diagnostic or intervention purposes. Okay, that's it for now. Best we will find it in the PPT. All right.